Hello friends, today in this tutorial I will be telling you that how to send emails to your Gmail account using Django 3. So Django is a popular Python framework, so this is a short little application that we will be building. So let me show you the application. Here I have put all the configuration settings. Here you can see that this is my email address, this is a password, and this is my Django server running on localhost 8000. And now basically if I open this address once again, you will see if I open this, this will take some time and this will say that email sent successfully inside a heading. So basically if I open my email address, you will see that this is a sample subject. And if I open this message, you will see this. Let me just open this. Let me just delete this and show to you guys once again. So let me delete this. So now if I once again refresh this, so it will take some time. And once again, if I refresh, you will see it will send this message. So you can see that this is a message. So if I open this message, so this is a test sample message. So in this way, you can send out test emails inside Django 3. So all the source code of this video is given in the video description. So if you go to the video description, you will be redirected to my blog here. So if you go to this blog, you will find step-by-step instruction on how to create a new Django project and then set up this functionality. So all the source code is also embedded, and I will also be showing this inside a video as well. So don't worry. So open this blog for your reference. So as I already told you, we will be building this. So let me just stop this server and close this folder. And let me also close this from Visual Studio Code here. Let me close this. So let me just delete this folder here. So this is brand new folder here. You can see that Django send email. So create your folder, and right here inside your command line, first of all, make sure that you install Django by executing a command, which is pip. Pip is a Python package manager. So pip install Django, that's it. So this is a simple command. Execute this command. I have already executed it, so this will take some time, and install Django globally onto your system. And now after installing Django, we will create a project simple with the help of this command, which is Django admin. Let me just write this command: Django admin start project. So let me just see the syntax here. Start project, and then your project name. Let's suppose I give here Gmail send. This is my project name. So it will create this project. You will see that. Now you need to go to this directory, Gmail send. And now if I show you, this has created one directory, which is Gmail send. This is your project level settings here. So you can see that you have this manage.py file. And if I open this project level settings here, you will see let me just open this inside my command line. So let me open this inside Visual Studio Code. So after creating a Django project, you need to create a sample app inside Django. For every Django application, you need to create some sort of app here. So for creating an app, the command is pretty simple. After you are inside the directory of your project, you need to execute python manage.py, and then you need to write start app, and then the name of the app here. Let's suppose I give it as send Gmail, like this. Send Gmail is my app name. So if I enter it, so you will see that it will create a apps folder inside your Django project. So you will see that this is my app here, send Gmail. If I open this app, you will see these much of files is there. So if I open the Visual Studio Code here, so there will be two folders. One is for the app here, and one is for the project, Django project. This is a directory structure, and this manage.py file will be there. So don't open this file, so just close this. And what we need to do is that the very first step is we need to add this app which we have created inside our Django project. For doing that, you need to click on your project and go to the settings.py file. So here inside this, you need to go settings.py file. So right here inside this file here, settings.py, go to this file and right here inside this installed app section, you need to add your app. So my app name was Send Gmail. So whatever your app name is, so add this app name. So it is very important. So Django will know that your app exists. After doing that step, you need to go to the urls.py file here inside your project, urls.py. And right here inside this, you need to copy paste the code that I am showing you. This is a code here. So let me just copy this. So remove all this and paste it here. And whatever your app name is, so in my case, this is Send Gmail. So replace this with your app name. So .urls, that's it. And just copy paste this code here. That's it. So it is simply telling Django that whenever, this is a home path here, you can see that. So whenever Django opens the home path, it should include this directory, which is Send Gmail, my app directory. And inside this, there will be a URLs file that we will create. And now we need to open our apps folder, which is Send Gmail. So right here inside this, we will create a urls.py file. So create a new file, which is urls.py. So inside this file, guys, we will copy paste the code that you find in the blog here. So as I already told you, it should be very important. So open the blog and for the code reference. So paste this code here. You will see that I am just telling Django is that whenever you open this home path, we will be manipulating this views.py file inside our apps folder now after doing this. So open this views.py. So here we will write our view, simple view. So here we need to copy this code here. So copy this code. Let me paste it. So from Django, there is a render method here. So whenever we make a request to the Django server, it will return this file to us alongside with the request. So we need to, for this file to exist, we need to create a templates folder inside our apps folder. So create a templates folder. Inside this, you need to create the folder which we have mentioned here, which is Send here. So inside this, you need to create Send, and then you inside this we need to create index.html. So I have shown you the directory structure in the blog also. So if you find here, you will see that create a template folder and then a Send folder and create an index.html file. And right here, copy paste this HTML code. Simple HTML code is there. A simple heading that email sent successfully. So after Django sent the email successfully, this web page will be shown to the user that email was sent successfully. And now what we need to do is that we need to initialize some settings inside our Django project. So this is there inside the project folder here. You can see that this is a project folder. Open this settings.py file, and right here at the bottom, you need to provide the settings for Gmail. So as we are developing for Gmail, so you can take any web server, for example. So right here at the bottom, paste this. So this is just your, here you will get your email ID and the password. So I will provide my email ID from which I will send out the email address like this. And then you provide the password. So I will definitely change the password after the video, so don't try to use this password. So you need to replace with your email ID and password. Apart from that, rest of the details remain constant. You don't need to worry about it. And one other important step that you need to take is that, so from wherever Gmail ID you are sending out the email address, you need to make sure that your Lex secure app access is on. For that, you need to go to your manage your Google account and go to security, and then you need to go to this less secure apps access and turn this on. By default, it will be off, but you need to allow this access in order to send out messages. That's it, guys. So after this, let me go to my blog here. After allowing this access, you need to write here, copy this again. You need to go to the views.py file. So just delete all this and paste this code here. So now we are importing a core library which is there inside Django, which is send underscore mail. So this is a function which actually do the business logic of this application, which sends out the email address to the email ID. So this is a simple subject and the body, the argument it takes. And the third argument it takes is your email ID, from where you are sending out it, the email address. So you need to type the email ID. And the fourth argument is the recipients. So you can provide multiple recipients. So in this case, I will provide my email ID. And then this fourth argument is a Boolean parameter, which is fail underscore silently. You need to set it to false. That's it. So now I think the application is complete. So now what we can do is that we can start our server by executing a simple command, which is python manage.py. And then you need to write run server. That's it. So this will start your Django server at port 8000. So it takes some time early on. So you will see that it has started the server on port 8000. And if I open this port, if I open the address, let's suppose localhost 8000. So you will see that it typically it takes some time for the very first time for sending out the message. And then it will print out that email sent successfully. You will see that. And now if I check my email address, you will see a new email address is there. Oh, email is there. So let me just delete it. The previous one is there. So let me delete this and re-execute this. So you will see a message will come here. Email is sent out successfully. So just wait. You can see that this is my email which I delivered to this email address. This is a test sample message. So you can also provide multiple email address. So if I go to temp email, so there is a disposable temporary email. So this is a great service if you want to test this application. So it will provide this temporary email address. So here you can plug it inside your application. So let me just make this like this. So now the application will send out these two email address at the same time. So if I refresh this, so it will automatically refresh. So it's a local, it will automatically save the changes and now it will send out this email address. So if I refresh here, so you will see that Sharma Gautam 1907. So if I open this, this is a test sample message. So in this easy way, guys, you can use this send mail function in Django 3 in order to send out email addresses in Django 3 application. And for the source code, you can go to my blog and download all the source code with step-by-step instruction. And thank you very much for watching this video. Please like the video, subscribe the channel, and I will be seeing you in the next video.